Just to quickly introduce ourselves, I'm Erica. Also here with me is Clara, my colleague.
Hello, everyone.
We both work for Europe Language Jobs, which is the company hosting the event. But we would really like to thank our sponsors, Fujitsu and Saito Portugal, for making this event possible for us. And we would definitely like to thank Laura from Jumping to Freedom for being here today and speaking with you guys about how to build a successful CV and cover letter. And Laura works for Jumping to Freedom, as we were mentioning. It is an association working on creating social impact locally in Spain and internationally. Their expertise lies in projects for both work and volunteering across Europe. So thank you so much, Laura, for being here, and I pass the word to you.
Thanks so much, Erica. Well, my pleasure. And especially thanks for Europe Language Shop for giving me this little space to talk. So as you know, by the title, we were talking about how to build a successful CV and cover letter, especially for positions abroad, which is mainly my expertise. So who am I? So I am Laura, and I have more than 4 years of experience in human resources, especially in talent acquisition and recruitment. And I am also the founder of Jumping to Freedom, which is a nonprofit organization that specializes in European-funded programs. Basically, we match organizations with talents through these programs. And the benefit from them is that you will get paid for your travel cost, and also will get relocation help. We also do project proposal writings for funding. So if you are a small group of young people in Europe, we also assist you with the writing for a proposal to get fundings for social activities that you will be doing locally in your community. And we also have on our website an academy with resources for European programs, but also for any other programs abroad that are not only for European ones, but also people that are not from Europe can also participate. So you can find all these resources in our website if you're interested. And basically, I started because when I finished university, I didn't know what to do next. I finished and I couldn't find a job where I was living. And I decided to relocate abroad, but always I was hoping that somebody could have helped me, but that help didn't come. So I basically managed myself to get to know more about these programs by doing them and researching them. And now I am more on the package stage, and I try to help other people to find these programs and to also be involved in them. I think when you actually have an international experience, it boosts a lot your CV and also your professional career, and I will encourage everyone to do so. So next, so why is so important an application first? So your application is basically your door to new opportunities. So without an application, you will not get any further into your career path if you don't apply to an opportunity. It looks simple, but it's like this. Like, even if you're aiming for an opportunity and you don't apply and don't invest your time in these applications, you will not get where you want to be. I don't know. So if someone is writing something in the chat, just let me know, Erica. So,
I believe they're saying they're having issues with the audio, but I can hear you. I don't know if you want to try perhaps without the headphones.
Okay. So now, can you all hear me?
Yes, I think we can hear you now.
Okay. Perfect. So if you cannot hear me, just let me know. So I'm not great at multitasking. So if I put the chat, then I cannot see my presentation and talk. So yeah, so just let me know if something happens in the meanwhile. So yeah, so we will be talking today about first the application process, what to do before and during. The CV, especially what to add, what to avoid, and how to have like a catchy CV. Also about the cover letter and the structure, and some steps to your dream position. So the application before the process. So if you're looking for a career change, I will encourage you to first focus on adding volunteering or even unpaid experience. Even personal projects also count. So if you have been a member of a club, let's say at the university, you have helped managing events, coordinating students, or anything related that you can have these duties on your CV, I will encourage you to do so, as well as, for example, a personal blog. So if you're applying for, let's say, a marketing position, if you have a personal blog and you manage all those social media, this could also be something to add. And especially highlight the tasks from previous positions related to the one you are applying for. If you have some experience that is not directly related, you can also have like a short section where you can put, let's say, irrelevant experience. And the one that is related to, is not so much related to the position you're applying for, I will encourage you to highlight, especially the skills that are more transferable, or let's say the duties that can have like points in common with the one that you're applying for. Also search by skills and tasks required, not by the job title. Many times they are like so fancy names about like the job title, and sometimes they can put you like back, kind of like for you to think that you cannot be applying for it. But I will encourage you to read the description and see if the duties are a great fit for you and you feel like you can do them. I wouldn't be like encouraged to apply because of this. So you should be encouraged to apply because you have this previous experience with the skills and the tasks. Also, I will say, follow your passions. So what really makes you happy? You will be like doing these tasks for 8 hours or even 7 hours on a day. So imagine if you are doing this and you don't like it, so it's gonna be complicated for you and also as well for the company to have someone who is not motivated. So in my opinion, you should do something that you really like and you're passionate about. And also ask yourself these questions about what you enjoy, what you're really good at, and where do you like to see yourself in the future. Especially about sectors and also experiences, the recruiter can tell if you have like really like a mix of like many different sectors and you don't know where you're going. So I will encourage you first to clarify yourself and ask you these questions and see where you are really looking to work in and to do in your life. Okay, so during the process. So when you are applying to a job, we all know that this is a job in itself, so it takes time really, and you can be really discouraged, especially when you don't receive any calls or any interviews, but you have to be persistent. So when I always looking for a new job, what I do is basically I set up an appointment to myself especially on the weekend. And when you are like at home, for example, when you're watching TV or you are in the sofa and you are like scrolling to your phone, and then I see a position that I really like or that I'm interested on, I add it to my appointment on my phone. And then when it takes the weekend, when I have more free time, I go through all the jobs that I added there, and then I see the ones that I would like to apply for it. So this way I kind of like organize my time and I don't need to drop everything because I found something that I really like and I want to apply, but I don't have the time. So this way is easier for me to be persistent. I also use a tracker. I usually have a super easy Excel sheet where I put the company, the position that I applied for, and the status. So basically you can put like, if you have already sent a CV, if you haven't follow up, or if you have, and this will make it easier to know that you are really working towards your dreams, and to also have like an idea of which companies you have already applied for and how is it going. Like if you have received a rejection email, then you don't need to follow up, but maybe if you haven't heard from them, you can also follow up with them with this tracker.
So then you are not like applying like crazy and you don't know to which company did you apply for. And when they call you, you have no idea when did you apply. So this will be a great way to be organized. Also be productive. So yeah, so as I said before, so while you are scrolling through your phone, all of us have this like free time when we do whatever. So at the same time, you can also be productive. And once you see something on social media about a position that you like, as I said, I will encourage you to add it to your notes on your phone and then check them out later on. So any of you have any questions till now? So you can use the chat if you like. Okay, so what to add to your CV? So now I will need all of you to write on the chat. So apart from, of course, the obvious one, which is the work experience and your education, what else do you think you should add to your CV? So you can type it on the chat so I can see you are not sleeping. You are also paying attention. Okay, so languages, your skills, certificates, yeah. Qualifications, strengths and hobbies, yes. Soft skills, volunteer experience. Okay. Office skills, interest, they show relevant skills, yes. Visa information, true. Internships, additional skills, contact details. Yeah, that's really important. Because otherwise, it's going to be complicated to reach out to you. So, yeah. So, let's say. So, what to add to your CV? You can add online and also offline courses, language you speak, your nationality, and also any visa permits that you might have, because even if you are not a resident in, let's say, in Europe, if you have a permit that will allow you to work until, let's say, the end of the year, it's going to be beneficial to you, and otherwise you might lose this opportunity because they think you are not eligible to this vacancy. Volunteering experience and also internship experience, also really important. Once you are listing the duties that you were involved in a particular position, to also add some achievements. So you can say, instead of saying I coordinated like different employees, you can also add together and say that you have been involved in the management of over 50 people in this and this and this and other country. So this will boost more than saying you just coordinated. So it will showcase to the company that you have been involved in different countries and also that you have the skills to, let's say, work remotely. So it's gonna be a bit different if you just say the duties or if you say more like the achievements as well. Any other relevant experience with transferable skills? So what I mentioned before, if you have a personal travel blog, you have been a member of a local group organizing events, you should also add this. Don't forget, where are you located? Sometimes if we apply for a position, you know that you will be relocating somewhere else, so some people forget to add, or they don't add their address, but I think it's really important, especially for the time zones, because it could be complicated to set up an interview with you. And it could be like a mix in time zones, and then it could be a mistake. So basically, I will especially add where you are located, even if you're applying for a remote position, which should be not so important, but at least they should know where you are at the moment for when they send you this interview invitation. And also where to find you. So basically, your telephone number, including the plus, whatever you need, the prefix for any country you are located, LinkedIn, otherwise the company, like 90% of the time will look it up anyway, so they will find you. So just to make it easier for them, I think you should add your LinkedIn. And if you haven't have a profile, I would recommend you to set it up because it doesn't take that long. And of course, the LinkedIn has to have the same dates and the same positions that you have on your CV. And also an email address. So regarding the email address, I will really recommend you, if you are applying for positions, to check sometimes the spam. Because let's say that they call you from your dream position and they send you an email and it went to the spam folder, you never heard of it, and you miss this opportunity. So I would recommend you especially to have an email where you can be reachable, and even better if you just use it for professional purposes. So Alexandra is saying, I struggle to bulletproof my experience talking about my achievements instead of my duties. So yeah, it is a bit complicated. Just think about what you can bring to the company. So maybe that's easier. Instead of just thinking what you have done in the past, think about what you have done for the company in terms of course, your particular position. So that will be maybe easier for you. So is everything clear till now? So if anyone has any questions, just type it. I hope I'm not going too fast. So, okay, so what to avoid in a CV? So looking to these two CVs, can you tell me what is wrong with them? Or what do you see that is like not so great? So especially the one on the right-hand side, in my opinion, it looks more like an invoice than a CV itself. And the one on the left-hand side, it says 2016. So which tells you that it's not really, even if it's updated, it doesn't look like it is. It is like a really old template. So yeah. So Paula is saying the design and Tambi is saying the structure, yeah. Not outstanding, yeah, that's for sure. Outstanding, but in the bad sense, really bad. A picture missing, well, that's not really a mistake. It's just, it depends. Each country will ask you for a picture and some of them will not, so. The marriage status, I will say it's not so important, but actually the one on the left have it. So what else? The veteran status, yeah, doesn't think, well, you can ask. You can be asked in case it does need it. So I wouldn't say that's really like something really, really important. So Hayley's is saying that it looks like a prescription, yeah, for me too. So like a doctor one. So. Okay, well, so these are two that I have received in the past, and they're real. They are from real people. So the one on the right, you can see, yeah. So they are saying like it looks like a balance sheet or like a bank form, and it's true. And there are also so many spaces that haven't been filled out. So would you just basically take it away? So why you just waste like some spaces in your CV if you're not gonna use it? So also when it says like the salary expected, it says $1. I think that's not hasn't been filled out really. And also the one on the left, the text is basically not centered and it has like many different fonts and many different colors and it's kind of confusing somehow. So the best, Alexandra is asking, the best structure for a CV is always, in my opinion, is always a PDF. So I wouldn't recommend you to send a CV in pages, which is from Mac, because some computers, if they are Microsoft, they couldn't read it and they will just like reject your application because of that. And also the Word one, I wouldn't also send it in a Word. I will always use a PDF. So Okay, so you know now what to avoid. So having a non-professional pictures, so do not use pictures of you cutting people off or with your dogs. I have seen a few of them, and also while you are traveling. So the recruiter can notice that all of these. So even if you think that because he's traveling and you cut it away, the person will not notice. I will also not recommend to use a graduation picture. It is not necessary to say that you just graduated. They will notice. And also it is, it's not like a plus for you that you have just recently graduated and you're using the same picture. You can just use like a blank wall that you have at home and take one with your camera or even with your phone. Like now they all have like this really high quality picture. So you don't need to go like in a special photo studio to have like a really nice one, but at least just have one that is just professional in some way. So do not use something that the background is kind of like noisy, or you cannot see yourself very clearly, or you can see that somebody took the picture from you and you are not really looking to the camera, for example. That's a no. Also, not all the time is needed a professional picture. Sometimes, for example, if you are applying for a position in the UK, most of the time a picture is not needed. So it's really up to you. So if you wanna use a picture, at least use a professional one. Otherwise, you can keep it without a picture. The second one is what I personally call, what about this? So when I see a CV, I am like, what about this? Because I am not really understanding completely what is happening. So some CVs has a gap or an updated date. So this means that if you haven't worked and you have been, let's say in a gap year, you can also add it. Like it's gonna be like an extra experience as well. You can say that you have taken a summer gap year and you have been exploring this and other countries. So this is a boost also for your international experience. So you shouldn't keep it away. And also it doesn't look so weird that you have like these dates that you haven't, that they are not sure what you have done. Also some irrelevant information. So as I said, if you, for example, have like a course that is not related to the position, you shouldn't add it. So let's say that you're applying for like a receptionist or marketing position and you're adding like a course about kitchen. So I don't think it's gonna be relevant. So you shouldn't add it. It's not gonna be like an added point. And also the grammatical mistakes. This is one of the main reasons as well for rejections on your CV. So you can use Grammarly, it's a free extension, and it will correct you as you go when you write on English. So especially on tests, like the cover letter, for example, it will correct you even the structure itself, and it will tell you that it's kind of like looking not so great, and you can also correct it with this information. I think there are some people asking. How many pages is the max? So in my opinion, the curriculum shouldn't have more than 2 pages. I don't think the recruiter is gonna read more than 2, honestly. So even if you have the opportunity to make it into 1, I think that's even better. So I have seen, it doesn't mean that because you have a longer experience, it's gonna be better. It's just the relevance of what you are saying on your CV. So even if it's 1 page and you can manage, I have long experience in my opinion, I have worked in many places, but I still managed to make it in 1 page. And for the rest, the recruiter can also ask. So you don't need to have like everything in there, like it's a dump CV, and just put everything you have done in there. So Ashati said, what is the problem with the 2 pictures? So these are the ones, if you're referring to the CVs, these are the ones that we have seen. So yeah, so the problem is what we said before, like they're not so great.
Laura, if you want, I can help you reading the questions, if it makes
sense. Yeah, because I I'm getting lost.
Perfect, no worries. The next one is, if we have an irrelevant experience and remove it, then we will have gaps. So what do we do then?
So I will say, as I recommend before, you can also have like a small section that says an irrelevant experience, and you can also add it there. So you don't have it like together where all the relevant information is, but you are still keeping it together in your CV, so it doesn't look strange that you have this gap. Grammarly problem.
Another one is, if one was on a sick leave for a year, should it be mentioned in the CV instead of having a gap?
A sick leave for a year is a lot. In my opinion, I will say that you should add it, in my opinion. So then they will know already that you couldn't work. So it's not that because you were not doing nothing, it's because you have this health. Mm-hmm. But otherwise, if you have been in sick leave for a year, I guess you have done something. Or otherwise, if you have been really, really sick, then no. But if you have been doing some kind of like volunteering, or maybe helping in some way, or doing some education courses while you were in this sick leave, I would recommend you to add it as well.
Mm-hmm. We skipped Luca's question up there, which was, I don't have work experience, just my internship to graduate from university. And then I moved to the United States to study. So he can work there as of now. How can I increase my chances when looking for a job? I feel like that's a huge disadvantage.
So as we mentioned before, it is not only important to have your work experience. So you just mentioned that you have your internship, right? So I will add this internship experience and also anything else related to your education. Your courses, any volunteering that you have done, and also you can use the achievement. I will say, for especially for someone who don't have that much work experience, the achievement section is really important, even if you have very little, and also your skills. So with this, in my opinion, you can fill your CV really well and still be outstanding for a company.
And the last question is, how is the best way to arrange the CV from the beginning?
So the best way to arrange? Well, in my opinion, you should always start with the work experience if you have. Second, it will be the education, and then also the skills, any other irrelevant experience, volunteering experience, and extra skills like courses or let's say a special section also to say that you have communications skills, your language skills, all of that. Yeah.
Okay, we actually have one more, and then if you'd like, we can keep the following questions for later on.
So the
last one is, I just finished high school and I want to go volunteering. How can I write a CV with no experience?
So especially if you're going to go volunteering, I will say you have an advantage when you are saying that you're really passionate about. So I will put like an emphasis, especially on the cover letter, to specify why you're really passionate about the volunteering you want to do. So maybe you're passionate about climate change and environmental practices. So I will personally explain that you have been really involved in this in your personal life. And this will also make a boost in your CV, especially when in your application, basically.
Perfect.
Yeah, so we can continue. Okay. So the third one is going to be the wrong format. So we just say in the one at the top, you can clearly see that everything is kind of confused and it's not right and centered. So I will avoid to use an centered text, also not so many different fonts, so two or three are enough, and also not too many colors. So especially the ones that are kind of like annoying are the yellow one for the eyes. So if you put like everything in yellow, most likely the recruiter is not gonna look, and nobody's gonna look because it's gonna be annoying to their eyes. So just also look for this kind of more pastel or at least more like neutral colors that are not gonna be like shock to when you open it. So we will talk about the CVs more now. Okay, so how to have a catchy CV, catchy CV. So there are some platforms like Canva. I will personally recommend to use this one, but there's a condition, which is you have to customize it with the colors and some extra sections. So you don't need to use it as it is. In my opinion, you can switch a lot. You can even have like two CVs and then mix them as you like with the sections. So when the recruiter open it up, they don't see 10 CVs that are the same ones with the same colors, because many people know about Canva. It's a free platform and it's quite easy to use if you don't know graphic design, but you have to invest some time as well to have this difference between everyone else. Also, you can invest in a resume template. So for example, there's Creative Market is kind of like a platform for many people who have been doing freelancing for graphic design. So you can find already made up templates to buy them. And they are really cheap because they are already made. So there's nobody who is actually doing them, doing for you. But it's true that not so many people invest on them, so not so many people have them. They also have one email that they send you every week on Monday that they have some free goodies as well to download. So from time to time, they have some fonts or some stuff for graphic design, but sometimes they have free templates for the resume. So you can also take advantage of this. This is not a sponsor, it's just something that I think is going to be beneficial. But if somebody knows any other platform where they can download also a template, you can just type it here. I think also Etsy will have some of them as well. Also, you can hire a video or graphic design to make your video CV, especially because this one is a bit more complicated one. A video CV is gonna be really boosting your application and make you stand out from many other applicants. And there are so many platforms like Fiverr where you can hire somebody for not so much money and they can make you a CV for you. So the one in Canva is the one on the right side. So if you don't know, well, if you can just type Canva on your own Google, you will find out the page because this is the main one. And also I wanted to share a video CV that we will see now. So just let me know if you can see it and hear it as well.
You can see
good grammar and spelling are important, but if you want to write essays that inspire, messages that forge brighter connections.
Sorry, the ad, as always.
After switching majors 7 times, dropping out, starting and failing a business, and then going back to university, my switch college years culminated with a degree in marketing from ASU. In the years following, I put on several hats in a few companies spanning a couple countries. I worked as a market research analyst, technology developer, brand creative, English teacher, national account manager. Fresh out of college, I worked with Las Vegas, big pharma, investment banking, and web tech industries. As a market research analyst, I made sense of customer satisfaction data, focus group sessions, one-on-one interviews, and open-ended survey comments. I helped Luxor keep its pyramid. I helped the tortoise and the hare get people to quit smoking. As a technology developer, I built business intelligence dashboards and automated reporting systems. It was me that reduced a tedious 2-week reporting process to 15 minutes. With a craving for creative work, I developed infographics and high-profile copy. My tagline appeared on Super Bowl 2008. A business trip took me halfway around the world to China. I fell in love. Within 2 months, I finished the marketing project, quit my job, sold everything, and moved. No language, no contacts, no plan. I thrived as an English teacher while I learned about life in an upside-down, exotic world. My teaching career blossomed quickly. As a teacher, I was ranked most popular for business English and sales grammar workshops. I consistently achieved fully booked classes with maximum participation, by combining the latest learning methodologies with facilitation techniques and exercises. After 2 years, my business career was calling me with a big opportunity in the Big Apple as a national account manager in the security industry. I made my mark here too. As a national account manager, I was named Rookie of the Year for being 108% Dakota and getting $1 million sales month. I sold a contract amounting to 451% of my annual quota the following year. Seeing the need for technology development, I built a sales calculator enabling the national sales team to demonstrate a 90% cost reduction over competition. Despite all my success, something is missing. My heart isn't in what I'm doing. I haven't reached my dream yet. I must keep pushing. There is more to learn, more experience to gain, but now I have so much to give. Whiteboard animation, storyboarding, diagramming and process documentation, strategy planning, facilitation, infographics and data visuals, automating processes, architecting user experiences, designing curriculum, creating and building brands. I am on a quest for specific knowledge and experience. I see how the pieces fit together now and what comes next. I have found my purpose to pioneer new ways to connect, to engage and persuade in more compelling forms of interactivity and relationship building. I must gain experience in programming, web design, web development, user interface design, animation, learning management systems. If you need what I can offer, and you can offer what I need, let's talk. Life is a journey, and maybe ours will bring us together for greatness. What big idea can I help you build?
Can you all see the main presentation now?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, perfect. Yeah, so this is an example. It's true that it's a bit long. It's like 3 minutes, but
education is a
sorry, just jumped the app from behind. So so basically what I would recommend you to do is also to have your CV, and maybe you don't need to have a professional video CV. You can also have just your CV as always, as the one that we have shown before, and also add like a small link that will go to YouTube. So you can also have it on a hidden link, so nobody can see actually your video unless you give them the link. And this will also help for the recruiter to get to know you a bit more before you actually apply. And it's also great. So you don't need to have, in my opinion, this one is gonna be for only when you apply with this link. But if you're applying with your traditional CV, you can also do it for like just 1 minute, talking about main things like I speak these languages, I am passionate about this, this and that, and then your work experience, and that you really would like to have a discussion with your company to see what you can bring to the team. And that's it. So it doesn't need to be really complicated. These are just a few suggestions. So you can go as further as you like. So these are some other examples. So especially the one on the right is for illustration, and the last one on the left is for graphic design. So you can see they are really great structure, and also they really showcase what is the relevant position, so you can tell, even if you are not reading it, you can tell somehow what they really want to work in, like the sectors. Also, we have these ones that I found on Instagram. So yes, these are CVs, especially the one on the left, which is for My Protein. It's a protein company. And I think they're really creative, especially for positions that require this level of creativity. I think it's really important. So it will be great if you can type on the chat which one do you like more from the four of them. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, just to see, to do a little survey. Also, it looks like the third one is winning, the one for Universal Music, and also the first one. Yeah, so I really like also the Red Bull one because it is using really the branding from the company, and it's really specialized on what the person is applying, which is just for this. So, well, actually all of them. So yeah, the font is hard to read because I have it in, these are screenshots. So it's not like this. So when you open it up, it will be bigger, but these are not mine. I'm just sharing them in a smaller version. So the quality is not so great. Yeah, so these are just to give you some other ideas that you don't have to use always like a traditional form. Sometimes to stand out, you will need to be a bit more creative and spend some time, especially if you're applying for an international company and you can find many information about the company online. I will encourage you to spend the time building a CV that is more tailor-made. And this way, for sure, you will receive a call or an interview or at least a compliment about what you have done. So, okay, so general tips, as we said before, if you are using this Canva platform or any other similar one that many people are using, I would recommend you to customize it and also to use all the space available. So if you are using two pages, maybe you can see if you have many open or blank spaces in the first page, maybe add it there. Also apply on the language of the vacancy. So it's simple as that. Many times I post a vacancy which is in English and I receive applications in French or even in German, in other languages that are not related. So if you have doubts, always apply on the language of the vacancy where it's showing you the description. And also, please make sure that you read what they are asking for. So this is another main reasons why people are rejected. So most of the times I ask for people to at the top of the cover letter to add their nationality, and maybe 40% of them, they do it. And the rest, they don't even read this part. So I still go through these CVs, but it's true that it kind of show that you are, when they are giving you a task, maybe you are not reading it completely or you don't really understand. So even if it's not the case, it looks like it is. So at least when you're applying, you should pay attention to what they're really asking for. Sometimes they ask you some questions in between the whole description that you will need to reply on your cover letter. So some companies are really strict with this, and once you haven't replied to anything that they are asking, they will just reject your application even before they have even opened your CV. So how to send your CV via email? Especially when you are sending it via email, never send it without a title. First check if there is a specific subject that you should be applying for. So let's say that at the beginning they ask you for a marketing internship with a reference number. So you should add this to the title. Otherwise, just state the title of the vacancy you're applying for. And if you add your name, it's also great because once the recruiter is also trying to find you on the email, they don't get lost. So they can find you more easily. Also, if you know the name of the recruiter, this is a plus. So you should send an email starting with dear, whatever the name. Or if not, you can say dear Red Bull team, for example. And also don't forget that if you're applying via email, you can follow up after 1 or 2 weeks to see how is the process going, to show your interest. Okay, so the cover letter, what to add. So at the beginning of the letter, explain how did you discover this opportunity. You can say, dear Red Bull team, my name is Laura and I am applying because I found this opportunity in the Europe Language Jobs portal. Then why this is important, why this is interested to you. So you just express your passions here. Make sure you add, as I said, anything related to the instructions. Sometimes they even ask you if you have your earliest start date. This is a really common question. Or sometimes your salary expectations. So you should add this mostly at the beginning so they know that you have read the what they are asking for. Also express briefly why you are the best fit according to your experience and to your personal motivations. Always remember that it's not what they can offer them to you, it's you what you offer to them. So basically you will need to say that you will be a great addition to the team because you can bring a positive attitude instead of saying that you will be really happy because you need this opportunity. So nobody's gonna give it to you because you need it. It's more about them than it is about you. Also the cover letter shouldn't be too long, but also not too short. So just for sure, like 3 sentences is not enough. So you can write a bit more about you, and this is your opportunity. So you shouldn't miss the advantage of adding a cover letter when it's required. So many times, I see that people send me CVs without adding anything else to the cover letter. And this is an opportunity that they are missing because they can show also their personal motivation, which cannot be seen, let's say, on a CV, and they are missing this opportunity. So this is a template that I have created, so you can use it. It's quite simple. So you can screenshot if you like, or I don't know, Erika, if we are sending this this presentation later on. So in my opinion, if they would like to have it, they can have this whole presentation on a link as mm-hmm. well. So as you mentioned that you will upload it on YouTube, maybe you can add the link and they can have it for later.
Perfect.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, so this is for you, for you all, so you can use it and also add anything else if you like. So steps to your dream position. So first, search vacancies you are interested in. This is so important. So just don't apply like crazy. Just apply to the ones that you are really passionate about and dedicate time. As I said before, it is really important to be organized, to have like a tracker, just a simple sheet of Excel. And also to not be discouraged because you are not having time to apply. So just be organized and have like a date or two on your week dedicated to apply. So this will be easier for you to do so. You can also play like music on the background or whatever, but just be motivated so you can be more happy while you do so. Prepare your CV, so mainly this will be for sure in English. Apply with intention. Also prepare your interview for any type of question. So when they ask you something, you know what to say. Basically, so just prepare. The last one is actually in Spanish. Okay, so it's prepare for your new adventure. That's why it's sorry, I forgot to translate. So yeah, so that's all. So thank you so much for listening. If you have any questions regarding this, anything that we have mentioned on the presentation, you can send me an email, and you can also follow us on social media if you want to know more. We share a lot of tips for interviews, for CVs, and also for these programs that I mentioned abroad. So, and if there is any questions now, I can...
We do have a few questions already, Laura. Okay. So the first one is coming from Rona, and it is, do you have any suggestions for softwares or platforms for producing a video CV?
So I said before, Fiverr is one that you can use. And there are so many other freelancing ones. And there are some people who can do your CV for like 20 or 30 euros. There are some people who are actually specialized in these animated videos. So you can do it with yourself, like showing yourself. And maybe here you can add some details. or as the one that we saw before, you are not there, but you are just explaining like your whole experience, background, and education. Yeah, Fiverr, so like this.
Perfect. Another question is coming from Francesco, and he's asking if there is other any specific platforms to help writing a cover letter.
So in my opinion, the cover letter shouldn't be have like something really special. It could be just like a word that you open up and you just add the information there. So I wouldn't use any special template for this, to be honest, because from most of the times when you apply, there's also a way to upload your CV and also like a blank space to add your cover letter. So you don't really need any extra document to be added. In my opinion, the cover letter should be as easier as possible and not add anything like colors or anything strange. It will be more like a letter. So yeah, that's it.
Perfect. Another question is, how can I express that I'm the best for the position without sounding arrogant?
Well, you should express it by using the keywords that the company is giving to you. So then they will kind of like connect the dots between what you know and what they are offering. So especially you can say that you have great communication skills without saying that you are the best at communicating, for example. Mm-hmm. So just showcase your skills.
Perfect. And in this case, to continue with the question, if there is no space for a cover letter in the application portal, can this person add the cover letter in the first page of the CV?
So yeah, you can actually, the CV should be the first one and then the cover letter should be the second one. So you can attach them together. Otherwise, some portals, what they do is that you have one space for the CV and another one for other documents. So you can also add it there, but never miss the opportunity to add a cover letter because it will give you this extra opportunity for the company to get to know you.
Another question is, any tips for middle-aged 50s experienced professionals?
Well, so I'm sure that you will have a lot of experience. So that's for sure something to add. In my opinion, senior positions are also really needed. And some companies are looking for people who are really experienced. So you should show this on your application for sure.
Perfect. One last question. And then for those who have asked for the slides and for the cover letters and CVs, we will be sharing this recording of the workshop on YouTube. So the last question is, if I copy words from the company's vision published on their website and paste them in my cover letter, is that okay? Is that good? Or would it look bad?
I will say no. No, you shouldn't do that because it's just copy and pasting. You should never copy and paste. You should just see their vision and their mission and then relate it to your application, but never just copy and paste it. Yeah.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Laura, again, for responding to all of those questions. As we were saying, we will be adding this. Thank you for sharing your Instagram as well.
Yeah. I will share, and I will also share my Facebook just in case somebody would like to.
Perfect. If you guys would like to add Laura on LinkedIn, on Instagram, on Facebook, she just shared her profiles. If you guys have any questions for her, she shared her email as well. We do have our email if you guys would have questions for us, because as you may know, we are a job portal. So if you guys are looking for jobs across Europe with your languages, feel free. It is actually a free portal uploading your CV. Hopefully you guys took in the tips that Laura shared with you guys. And if you have questions for us as well, you can send it over. We can forward them to Laura as well. And thank you so much for participating. We hope you guys enjoyed.
Thanks everyone.